Indonesia, up against the new world number threes, so they're the only number five seeds here, Jeong, Naung and Kim Hai Hei Jeong. So this is the women's doubles draw. In the top half of the draw, and the match we're going to concentrate is right at the bottom of those eight pairs. As you can see, the former champions, the winners in 2019, Chen Qingcheng and Jia Yifan, the reigning and three-time world champions, they're safely through. And the Stoyeva sisters, who actually beat Pearly Tan and Tina Muralitharan, the number eight seeds, they are also through to the quarterfinals tomorrow. Well, here are the number five seeds, Jeong Naung and Kim Hei Jeong.
City, Fadira, Salvia, Ramadhanti, Indonesia.
Who, since the seedings were done, have moved up to a career high of three. And here are the defending champions, unseeded this year, despite holding the title. Apriani Rahayu and Sidia Fadia Silva Ramadhanti won the title last year, beating Zhang Shushuan and Shegu in the final, having beaten Matsuyama and Shida on the way, and Chen Qingcheng and Jia Yifan. In fact, this is a repeat of the semi-final from the last Malaysia Open. And that is the only previous time that these two pairs have met. Two straight games a year ago in this tournament in 44 minutes. Close second game, as you saw. So the toss of the coin.
Side with side.
The Koreans won the toss of the coin and have chosen ends.
Who will receive? Ramadhanti will receive. They receive and Jeong to serve.
So the Indonesian pair have chosen to receive. So it was a remarkable tournament last year for these two Indonesians. It was only their fourth tournament that they'd played together. But here is Jeong Naung, 22 years of age, born in the Korean capital of Seoul. As I was telling you, they have, since the seedings were done, gone up to a career high of number three, third consecutive week at number three. Only their second appearance as a pair. Kim Hei Jeong is making her third appearance, because in 2019 she reached the second round with Kong Hee Yong. She turned 25 earlier this month, in fact 9 days ago to be precise. And in their first round, they beat the English pairing of Chloe Birch and Lauren Smith. Nice to see Lauren back after an ankle injury. But two straight games, just 36 minutes for the Koreans to beat the English pairing. This is the Olympic champion, Apriani Rahayu, making her fifth appearance at this event, but her second with her partner of today. 24 years of age, from Lawulo in the Kendari region of Southeast Sulawesi. And they, like their opponents, are playing off a career high. Their high is 11. It's their fourth consecutive week at their career high. Siti Fadia Silva Ramadhanti is making her third appearance. And she is 2 years younger than her partner. And she was born in Sibenon, West Java. Their first round was against Li Chia Sin and Tian Chun of Chinese Taipei. 21-16, 21-15 in 33 minutes. Now, if you were with us on Tuesday, you would have enjoyed that one with us. Lao Chen Liu of Malaysia, our umpire for this one. And Jeetan Bart from Australia is the service judge. Well, it was a remarkable start to the Indonesian partnership. Miss Kim Hei Jeong. And points. This lady, Kim Hae-jeong, is trying to emulate her mother, who won the Malaysian Open twice. Chung So-young won with two different partners, 1990 and 1991. Chung Myung-hee won her two partners that she won with. We almost had the child of a former champion win here before, didn't we? Because Ichuk Sugiarto won the men's singles, and
ladies
his
and gentlemen,
Tommy Sugiarto reached the final of the men's singles.
On my right.
But I don't think we've ever had
a
parent and child
Rahayu
win. History could be made.
Ramadhanti, Indonesia. And on my left.
A way to go, of course, before we contemplate that.
City Fadia Silva Ramadhanti. Level play.
So it is the Koreans Jeong Na-eun and Kim Hae-jeong getting the second round women's doubles underway against the defending champions Rahayu and Ramadhanti.
Seventh over. One love.
Was talking about the remarkable start to the partnership, the steam of Rahayu and Ramadhanti. They actually formed their partnership at the Southeast Asian Games in Hanoi last year. Won gold. And then in their second tournament, reached the final, the Indonesian Masters. In fact, three finals in their first four tournaments together. I mean, that's absolutely extraordinary, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Highly likely that they go up in top 10 after this tournament.
Yeah. Good rally. Also plays mixed doubles, this lady. And Kim Wong Ho.
Well, they've already played today, haven't they? I think they made a big surprise.
Steam. They beat the Olympic champions, Wang Yilu and Wang Dongping. Two-time beaten finalists here at the Malaysian Open. They beat them 23-21 in the deciding game.
Yeah. It's a great result.
Yeah.
I think I called both Kim and Jones matches against the Amstrad sisters from Thailand at the World Tour Finals. And they were games in both matches. Lost the three last matches against the sisters, and they were sort of bombed out in those circumstances there. And I'm curious to see whether the Indonesians have the same kind of firepower, or they will have to do something else, because I thought that Kim and Jeong, they had something good going in that women's double.
Last year for this Korean pair. Their home event, the Korean Open, and also the Japan Open, which was a Super 750 event. Finished the World Tour last year, the Koreans at number one on the race to the World Tour Finals, at a level of their consistency.
Yep.
And a change of angle there from Rahayu. That a nice little block. Good rally. Oh, super angle. That was so steep from Ramadhanti. And so near that sideline, absolute perfection. Wonderful shot. Well left. My goodness. I do like the way, though, that women's doubles nowadays, I mean, we were talking about, I remember specifically talking about it at the French Open when Pearlie Tan and Tina Burra-Litherland won. But women's doubles now, you're seeing the defence where they're trying to be aggressive on defensive play. They're always looking for angles, always looking to see how they can get on the attack.
Yeah, it's a nice development. It's good man. Look at the flat game here.
Yeah. Oh, indecision. They both left it for the other, the two Indonesians.
So I think matches are interesting if there's diversity in them. Good attack by Kim here.
Like,
I mean, it's not interesting to see women's doubles play clear drop. Block. But it's not interesting to see a women's singles or a men's singles play clear drop block. We were there once where some players were playing a very defensive style and just retrieving everything. That wasn't really fun either. It's not really fun watching men's doubles just play only the first four shots of a rally.
Yeah.
The diversity, the challenge to find new solutions in terms of winning points, I think that's what makes it really interesting and enjoyable to watch badminton. And it tends to go in waves. So, like, if there's a really strong attacking pair, well, then some pairs better their defense so that they can challenge them and get rewarded in their own attack. I think men's doubles has, in my opinion, disappointed me a little bit because I don't think we've seen that defensive development that I would have expected. Or maybe it's just around the corner, who knows?
Yeah.
She's so quick on her feet, Kim Ha-jung.
Yeah.
Serve it slower. 8-10.
Is there a women's doubles player that's faster than her? I can't think of anyone. On her feet.
No. And she's very light on her feet, too.
Yeah, exactly.
She? Almost as if she's on her tiptoes the whole time. Point advantage to the defending champions at the mid-game interval here. Some excellent rallies so far. Well, Steen, I predicted on social media, now that I've joined the new world.
Yeah, welcome to the new century.
That women's doubles, and I thought men's doubles as well, would be fascinating this year. I think it's going to be interesting.
Some new combinations, in especially women's doubles, that are very interesting. You mentioned the Malaysian women's doubles. I had one more. It's gone now. We already know them. Matsuyama and Shida, unfortunately, not here. The Japanese combination. Are they second in the world at the moment?
They are.
11.
And they were the number two seeds here.
Yeah. I enjoy watching Zhang Xuxian and the pairing with Zheng Yu. And in this tournament, we've seen the European representatives, the Stoyeva sisters, strike back, defeating Murlitharan and Perlitan in the first round, and also securing their quarterfinal berth here. That's really nice to see them back in contention. Yeah, the Indonesians, the new combination with the Olympic champion Rahayu, and there's a few other young Indonesian pairings as well.
Look at this rally.
Good play.
Oh, don't believe it. How on earth did the Indonesians win that rally? That is remarkable. What fantastic badminton. We're just seeing the final few shots of the rally, but there was a defensive shot earlier on. I'm pretty certain it was from Ramadhanti that was out of this world. Yeah, and it's not just the pairings and new pairings, Steen. It's the way they're playing women's doubles. Yeah. You know, this tournament, we've seen two new pairs from China. They actually played against each other earlier on, but, you know, I think we're going to enter a time where women's doubles, not necessarily more diverse as far as nationalities are concerned, but certainly more different pairs in with chances of winning any given tournament.
Malaysia coming forward with a pair that can win tournaments, that's new. I think Thailand is about to have three strong pairings. The Amsat sisters really impressed me at the World Tour Finals. They made a new combination with Pev Samplan and Supachirakun, and then the more experienced combination of Jongja and Kitanarakun. So they have three strong pairs, and if you have that many pairs, then they can spar against each other, they can spar against the boys, and that just bodes for a good environment for development.
Yeah, I agree. Well, at the start of the match, Steen, you asked whether whether the Indonesians would have enough firepower. Has that been answered yet?
Yes, they have. They have enough, I think, but not excess firepower like the Amsat sisters, who's a bit taller and with a net player in terms of little sister Benyaka as the front court player to intercept and so on. So they have to work a little bit extra. They can do that, Ramadhanti and Rahayu, good defense themselves.
Oh, it was the right idea from Rahayu, trying to change up the pace.
14.
Saw that Rahayu was committed to her backhand defense. It hit on a forehand side. 15. Great awareness. Exasperation there, I think, between the two Korean players. And they both went for the same shot. Body language suggests they weren't entirely happy.
Thank you.
Yeah, super rally.
13, 16. No, they are ready, no.
That's going to go long.
14, 16.
Defensive play by the Koreans, or perhaps a little bit going for too much by the Indonesians. If you never go for it, then the opponent simply gets too settled in, gets too confident.
His defense. Fabulous running again. Yeah.
Looks a little spent outside the picture. Look at the way she looks at that.
I'm too happy with herself. Longest rally so far. 71 shots.
Take the game, but were they behind 16-11?
16-11.
Yeah, and then there was this mistake by Kim at the net and the long rally where they played the outright winner, the Indonesians. Otherwise, the Koreans have scored 5 points.
That's a good serve, isn't it? Brilliant. Super drive defense from Ramadhanti.
19-16.
On their first 21-16, the opening game to Austria's
Rahayu
champions,
and City Fadila Rahayu Ramadhanti.
And City Fadila Silva Ramadhanti. 25 minutes for that opening game. And what an excellent opening game it was. Good aggressive play. Some wonderful defence, especially from the Indonesians. And the rewards. Hian, Indonesian coach, my goodness, he's done a good job with the Indonesian women's doubles players over the last few years since he returned to Indonesia.
To the discussion about the women's doubles, I suddenly thought I remembered seeing something that Kim and Jeong here, that they were going to split up and that Kim was going to play with Kong Hee-yong, who she played the Uber Cup with successfully, but I couldn't find it, and tried to see the entry list to some of the following tournaments in Indonesia and Thailand, and the interesting thing there is that the other two pairs from Korea, Lee Seo Hee, Shin Sung Chan, here in the tournament, and Baek Han Ah and Lee Yoo Lim, they're splitting again, like we saw it in Denmark and French Open in the last two tournaments on this Asian swing here in January.
Yeah, that's interesting. Well, of course, Lee Seo Hee and Shin Sung Chan were the number four seeds here this week, and they lost in the first round to Du Yue and Xia Yu Ting.
Yep.
So you never know whether they're upset that they've been split up and therefore weren't firing on all cylinders, or whether, because they're not firing on all cylinders, that's why they've been split up. Straight points now. From love three down to 5-3 up. Oh, indecision. Thank you. Oh, brilliant from Kim Hae-jeong. That defensive shot where she pushes this little one, half court area, follows forward as well. You know what, Steen? I think she should play mixed doubles.
Yeah, outside the picture, Aparna Rahayu is almost up to talk to Engian. She's definitely talking to him. This should be noted by the umpire and say, hey, this is time wasting.
Yeah, good work from Ramadhanti.
Serve it over.
I thought that Ramadhanti was the decisive player on court in the opening game. I thought her defensive play, her blocks, her drives, and the accuracy of her attack was made the big difference. Are not getting out of their defensive play as well in the second game, are they?
No, they're not, and they're getting a little bit ahead of themselves in the attack. They're not patient. So they've got to find a different way than the all-out attack, straight-out attack like they did in the first game.
Block again from Ramadhanti.
And again, we see Rahayu walking all the way out to talk to the coach. Having seen a number of the other World Tour tournaments, I feel that the umpires here are not very active. In terms of running it out when players are taking too much time.
Oh, that's nice.
Great.
Oh, yes. There she is again. So proactive at the front of the court. Kim Hae-jeong. Interception. Positive in that rally from the Indonesians.
Ten.
Yes. Well played once more from Kim Hae Jeong. And the Koreans, the number five seeds, go to the mid-game interval with a five-point advantage.
I feel Kim Hae Jeong is about to take the role that you mentioned Ramadhanti had in the first game as the decisive player here in the second.
Yeah, I agree with that analysis totally. Korean coach, former champion here 14 years ago with Lee Ho-jong.
Players, back on court.
Well, 11-6 lead, and when you think that they were love three down, the momentum is most definitely with the Korean pair.
Two bad shots there. First the service and then the return. There.
Oh, that's a great take from Kim. Well left. Look at that. That was superb. Great racket work on the front of the court from this lady. She is again.
They're getting counter attacked.
14-7.
Well, the winner of the toss of the coin and the opportunity to choose ends, which is what the Koreans did, may prove decisive.
Yeah.
They shouldn't. Sport shouldn't be decided on the luck of the toss of the coin. Oh, brilliant put away again. Well, you've got to give Jeong Na-eun credit as well, because she's setting her partner up at the front of the court.
Exactly. She's supplying the firepower to activate Kim Hae Jeong on the front court. So, if I were the Indonesians, I think maybe it's a little bit too late now, but in the last phase of the third game, they're going to stand on those exact same sides as they do now. Good attack. They've got to attack, they're just going to stay in balance. They cannot afford to be counter-attacked. And then I would flick Kim Hae-jung because I feel that she's more dangerous on the front court and not making as big as impact on the back court as her partner. So I would put her on the back court and with much, much more flat lifts. Look how quickly she was coming forward there.
Yeah.
With much more flat lifts, so it gives opportunities for Rahayu and Ramadhanti to counter. Left one. Start all over. And Rahayu, they have from the midcourt area below the tape, they have a lot of slow-paced, sneaky shots to the midcourt area. Kim Hae-jung is there covering everything. They don't get anything out of those shots at the moment.
Points now, and the Indonesians could start to believe again.
Yeah, I just don't feel that they have sort of like earned the points.
Super. Wonderful shot. 3 points away from the third game. Surprised that they haven't made more attacking winners in this second game, the Indonesians, because they're hitting with the drift.
Yeah, but I would like to reevaluate my answer on the firepower thing, because that's what's been pretty clear here in the second game, that when the Koreans can play defense without having to worry about putting it on, then there isn't really enough firepower to just kill it immediately from the attack. They've got to play variations. They got to make sure they don't get counter-attacked themselves. Rahayu and Ramadhanti, and that's where the Emsad sisters, with their height, smash strength, and their reach at the front court, made a much bigger impact on the Koreans.
Oh, fabulous play from Kim Hae-jung. Game point opportunities, seven of them, to level this at one game apiece. Nice angle, and very fitting that second it was Kim who played the winning shot in this second game, because as Steve was pointing out earlier, she has been the decisive player in this second game. Look at that, it's fabulous, wonderful angle. It's almost a pearly tan shot. So one game all, 21-13, the second game. 52 minutes into the match, third and final game coming up. So third and deciding game in the second round women's doubles. Oof. Well, that's pretty good. Yeah, it's not worth a challenge on the very first point of a deciding game. You need to have some challenges up your sleeve in the latter stages. Well, a little bit of a difference between whether the shuttle should be changed or not. The Koreans wanted it changed. The Indonesians said no. All part of the psychological battle of sport.
Service over.
Started with a good return of serve.
Yeah. That meant that they couldn't get the right length on the first lift, the Koreans, and it's dangerous.
Yeah, that's a good smash towards the right hip of the Ramadhanti. Ramadhanti actually stood between her partner and the shuttle, so she couldn't possibly play it, had to leave it, and it was the right decision. Superb play from Kim Hae-jung. Isn't it fascinating that we saw that shot, that cross-court drop from the forehand side of Kim right at the end of the second game. Now, until Pearlie Tam started playing that, I don't think it was often used in women's doubles. Now, all the players are, or not all the players, but they've obviously learned from other players, and other players are now trying it.
Of course, it's working, so yeah, we want to do the same.
Yeah.
When are we going to see tumble serve in women's double? I've seen in the mixed doubles Lisa Kusumawati from Indonesia serving in tumble serve. Same kind of focus on the service situation though, so it might not be just as successful as in men's double.
Service over. Six.
What about
four.
The flick serves then? Is people going to experiment with that?
Well, when the spin serve, the Sadek serve first came in, I certainly used it, lots of the women used it. So, I mean, I don't understand why they're not, the women's doubles players aren't using the tumble serve. Of course, the Sadek serve was outlawed. You're not allowed to hit the feathers first, which is what we did with the Sadek serve. Just wide.
Seven, four.
limiting their attack from that side, so they've got to come up with other solutions.
So another one missed.
8-4.
Now, if she drops her standard, Kim, that's going to have a big impact on the Korean pair.
Yeah, but it's from the backcourt. It's from the backcourt, and that's the plan, to put her on the backcourt, because her impact is much bigger when she's on the front court, sort of like covering everything. And, speedy-like footwork.
There was an early call from Rahayu to her partner to leave that. Four straight points. Do you know, that was just going through my mind.
Yeah, you're not going to get any counter chances if they give it that much height.
Touched her shoulder. Umpire says no.
No change.
Every little point they can get together, the Koreans could become crucial for them.
Points are now only 1 point in it. I think you're right, Steen. I think this could be a crucial little run.
Yep. Two of the last 3 points they've scored, the Koreans came out of nowhere.
Thank you.
she was having to move back in court to play that one. Misjudged the angle that it needed to be played. Slightly off balance. And it means that the defending champions have a 2-point advantage at the change of ends here in the third and deciding game. Question is, for the defending champions, is that enough of a lead?
Very animated learning camp compared to his normal coaching.
Yeah.
He managed to get off the court before Lee Kyung Wong. That's not often that happens.
No. No, Lee Kyung Wong usually has a very quick word and they're gone. So 11-9, deciding game.
Suddenly stops. What's going on? Think they can challenge Kim Hae-jung on the front court from below the tape. They're getting punched in the nose. I don't think that's a good plan. Everything about the Indonesian play in that rally. Patience in the attack and then looking for the counter opportunities. That's the way to do it.
Third shot. Oh. She is incredible, isn't she?
Service over.
Kim Hae-jung.
11-13.
Thank you. they both went for the same shot, the Koreans, and clash of rackets meant that neither of them hit it properly. This one just pops up.
Kim.
In fact, who did hit it? No, I think it was Jeong.
Yeah, I think so too.
She's run off to get a new racket. Unbelievable.
15, 11, keep, keep, keep.
She went from the deep forehand corner to run off and change the racket. Look at this. Deep forehand corner. Off she goes. She couldn't have been further away from her racket bag.
Keep.
Okay. You gotta love it.
Some sort of relay mixed doubles with Victor Axis, and they have to go and change the racket every time they hit a shot.
Oh, that's a shot again. What a rally. That's athletic play, isn't it? What a great
16,
smash from Rahayu.
11.
There's some openings eventually in the rallies when they go past a certain number of shots. Openings are created on Jeong Na-un, the way I see it.
Well, that was a nice idea.
17.
That's a second service error from Kim. Helped by the net cord there.
18, 12.
Stepped up as well on the Indonesian side. A little bit lucky here, but they've really played well in the last part of the third game here.
Yeah, because I thought only that 2-point difference at the change of ends.
Wasn't too much.
No. The Indonesians have done well to pull away. 6-point advantage now. Sure, this isn't.
13,
yeah, she's
18.
Hurt herself.
Her hamstring.
But back defense from Ramadhanti. Oh, yes. went into sort of the splits position. Yeah, that will have hurt. Ooh.
Players, back on court.
I don't think you and I would ever recover from that sort of fall, would we, Steen?
No, they would have to pick up pieces of my leg or from all around the arena.
Still tried to play on, even though she was in pain. Short. Yeah. That's very efficiently dispatched by Kim.
14-18.
She's got lovely skills, but she's also got a good badminton brain.
Yeah, the thing is, I want Rahayu to move forward. Oh, that was the shot before. I wanted to move forward and raise her racket instead of in conventional defensive position, because she's not the tallest of athletes, Kim Hae-jung, and she hits a very flat smash. So you've got to sort of make sure you have a position where you have a chance to counter.
Yeah. Yeah. Well played by Ramadhanti.
Serve is over. 19-14.
Point opportunities.
Best point,
and since the change of end, Steen, you're absolutely right. The Indonesians have played extremely well. Now Ramadhanti has stepped forward when necessary, as she did in that rally. Six match points for the defending champions. Super shot from Ramadhanti to close out this second round match. The defending champions beating the number five seeds, Jeong Ha-ong and Kim Hae-jung, and beating them in three excellent games. 21-15 in the deciding game. Just under an hour and 20 minutes.
Match won by Apriyani Rahayu and Siti Fadia Silva Ramadhanti. 21-16, 13-21, 21-15.
Umpire just confirming that scoreline. This is the final rally. What a wonderful shot from Ramadhanti to close it out. Great awareness, and I think her defensive play and her blocks and drives had a really significant impact on the outcome of this match. So the defending champions, Apriyani Rahayu and Siti Fadia Silva Ramadhanti, safely through in three games, beating the number five seeds from Korea, 21-16, 13-21, 21-15 in the deciding game in an hour and 19 minutes. Welcome back to Kuala Lumpur. It is day three of competition at the PETRONAS Malaysia Open 2023. Second round action all day today. That's what's happened so far. And next up, we have men's doubles, and it's the Olympic champions, Li Yang and Wang Chilin from Chinese Taipei, up against the Koreans.